Whether you reach excellence or not depends on what is your belief.
Your network decides your net worth. Network with the right people who can help you do your SWOT.
Don't take the risk of quitting your current job to follow your passion. What if the passion stuff doesn't work? Who will pay the bills? Your passion?
Top 10, I got a top 10. Got my motivation high for my top 10. Gotta learn from the wise women and men. All my life, like nine.
Need motivation?
Watch a top 10 with Believe Nation.
Hey, it's Evan Carmichael, and this channel was created to help you overcome the number one challenge that is holding you back, a lack of belief in yourself. You watch these videos because you know there's something greater inside you. You have Michael Jordan level talent at something. So get ready to believe, just be you, and don't neglect your passion with Guru Gopal Das and my take on his Top 10 Rules to Success Volume 7 to give you the belief, confidence, and motivation that you need. Enjoy. Okay, let's kick it off with rule number one, believe.
What do you believe in? Do you believe that I can do it? Or do you believe that I can't do it? Whether you reach excellence or not depends on what is your belief. Do you believe that come what may, I can do it and I will do it? Or do you believe, I don't think I have enough resources, I don't think I have enough support, I don't think I have enough people who can help me with this, so I don't think I can't reach the, I can reach there. What's your belief? I can or I can't? That decides whether you're going to get there. I understand in real life, you may say, oh, it's nice to give a pep talk sitting there, you know, saying, okay, you should believe that you can, you should believe that you can, but we don't have the resources, we don't have the support. Successful people who reach excellence are those who don't wait for resources to come. They start with what they have. They start from where they are. Because they start from where they are and what they have, even if it's little, with the right kind of absorption practice, they reach where they want to be one day.
Rule number two, just be you.
A plum once said, oh my dear Lord, can you please make me a banana? God said, why? It's because that guy loves banana. So God said, tathastu. So the plum became a banana. So then the guy came. Instead, he purchased orange. Ye plum banana bana. Uske liye aur usne orange kharida. So he said, God, please make me an orange. So the banana, God was tathastu, became an orange. So the guy came, picked the orange, bit him, phoo, spat him, kadwai. Then he said, my dear Lord, can you please make me grapes? God said, tathastu, became grapes, and the guy didn't even look at the grapes. And the grape said, how I wish I remained a plum. There would be someone who loves a plum who would come and take me. Ladies and gentlemen, we are all different. Hum sab alag alag hain. Bhagwan ne hum sab ko alag alag banaya hai. Hamare swabhav alag hai. Hum dikhte alag hai. Hamare likes, dislikes alag hai. Everyone's an individual. Everyone's different. आप दूसरे के जैसा क्यों बनना चाहते हैं? क्यों किसी और के वजह से बनना चाहते हो जी? क्यों भगवान का अपमान कर रहे हो? उन्होंने आपको बनाया, क्यों उनका अपमान करते हो कि आपने थोड़ा ठीक नहीं बनाया मेरे को, इसलिए मुझे उसके जैसा बनना है? हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू लाइक मैंगोज? वाओ, ओके, दैट्स अ रॉन्ग क्वेश्चन, सॉरी. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू डोंट लाइक मैंगोज? है कुछ ऐसे करेजियस आत्मा है इधर कोई? There's one, two hands who don't like mangoes, right? Just because someone likes mangoes, should a plum become a mango? Just because someone likes plums, should a mango become a plum? If you're a plum, remain a
plum.
If you're a mango, remain a
mango.
If you're an apple, remain a
apple.
If you are a guava, remain a guava. You were created to be a guava.
Rule number three, don't neglect your passion.
If your job pays you well, is it okay to overlook the satisfaction you get from it? Is it okay to forget your passion and continue slogging in a job that you don't like? Here's my answer. Assuming that you spend on an average about 8 hours a day at work and work a 5 days a week, that would mean spending 40 hours of your week at work. Now, assuming that you get 2 weeks of holiday every year, that would mean spending 2,000 hours of your year at work. Now, does that sound a lot? Well, let's keep going. Assuming that you spend 45 years of your life working, that would mean spending a daunting 90,000 precious hours of your life at work, which is approximately 10 years of your life. And if you're not happy with your work, guess what? You end up spending 8 hours of your day, 40 hours of your week, 2,000 hours of your year, 90,000 hours of your life in misery. Not sure if that's a great deal. I know what you're thinking. Following your passion doesn't pay the bills. Your calling doesn't clear the loans and mortgages. After all, those who slog it out are the ones who have better cars, better houses, better holidays, a better life. A better life? Well, debatable, isn't it? I completely understand and agree that you can't quit your current job because you have real needs in the real world. But at the same time, I'm also asking you whether it's fair to spend 10 years of your life in pain. I know that those of you who are watching this video are shouting, enough of Max, sir. Please tell us, what's the way out? Here's my proposal. Don't take the risk of quitting your current job to follow your passion. What if the passion stuff doesn't work? Who will pay the bills? Your passion? But at the same time, don't neglect your passion and be a nervous wreck at work. Try and find the right balance. Step one, if not everything, identify some part of your current work that you may possibly develop some liking for. That will make your 40 hours a week a little less painful than now. No one has a perfect job, exactly like no one has a perfect partner in marriage. But when you identify those aspects of your spouse that you love and connect to that, the elements that you don't necessarily like in your spouse become a little easy to handle. Deal with your job the way you deal with your spouse. Focus on and highlight the positives and work through the negatives. Step two, start pursuing your passion side by side. Maybe it's very small in the beginning. Maybe it can be done only over the weekend. But when you do what you love, not only will you find deep satisfaction, but also the ability to handle what you have to do at work through the week. And you know what? Maybe one day your passion will become your profession, giving you fulfillment and the money needed to live in the real world.
Rule number four, practice, practice, practice.
When Tiger Woods was asked, what is his key or what is his secret to success? He said it's three words. And he said, practice, practice, practice. Tiger Woods said the three words to focus on in order to achieve success is practice, practice, practice. Yes, certainly we need the right kind of approach and skill set, and we need to practice it again and again to succeed and achieve excellence in any area of life Obviously. Let's say, for example, you're wanting to achieve excellence in your physical fitness, where your diet and nutrition and your exercise matters. You have to learn the right form of your workout, the right form of your exercises, and practice it again and again and again to succeed and achieve excellence in your fitness levels.
Also, if you want to have more motivation, self-love, and confidence, check out my 254 series. They're free. The links to join are in the description below.
No one on planet Earth can stop you from accomplishing and achieving what you want.
And whenever you're updating to a higher version of yourself, you have to be able to give the best of yourself to it. It's easy to make a buck, very hard to make a difference.
Rule number 5, network with the right people.
You know what is your net worth? Your net worth is your network. Your network decides your net worth. Network with the right people who can help you do your SWOT. You will feel greatly joyful when people tell you, think about your strengths. Everyone loves to think about their strengths. Weaknesses? Oh, we don't like to think about them. You need the right people in your network to tell you what your weaknesses are. I have mine. I have 2 or 3 friends of mine, very close in my network, who can tell me, ye bahut bada galti kar raha hai tu. This is your weakness. The greatest mistake we do in our lives is we don't want to listen to feedback. No one likes to listen to their weaknesses. It's an open heart surgery when someone tells you you're wrong. और एनेस्थीशिया भी नहीं देते वो लोग, ऐसा काटता सीधा, थोड़ा एनेस्थीशिया देता, मीठा मीठा बोल के काटता तो यार चलेगा, बिना मीठा बोले काट करके बोल देता है सीधा।
Rule number 6, learn to handle failures.
A little girl, daughter of one of the members of the spiritual community I am a part of, would stand first in class every year and would come to show her report card to her guru, whom she loved so much. When she was in her 5th grade, she stood first again and came running from the school to show her report card to her guru. As he carefully examined her marks and her performance, she was excitedly awaiting some words of appreciation from him, like he did every year. To her utter surprise, he asked her, "Why did you stand first?" She was shell-shocked. She had stood first, and rather than admiring it, he was asking why. Seeing the confusion and bewilderment on her face, he remarked, "It's wonderful that you've stood first for all the years of your school and this year as well. It is definitely commendable, and you indeed are a very hard-working girl. But you should remember that great results are not the only barometer of your success. Your sincerity, your hard work, and your understanding of your school subjects are your true achievements. And also, life will not necessarily allow you to stand first always. After all the hard work, if you happen to stand second, or even if you happen to fail, it's all right. You've given your best. And now you also learn a new lesson, how to handle failure. Life is a roller coaster ride with ups and downs, successes and failures. Keep working hard. Keep standing first. Learn the lesson of accepting your success with humility. And when you fail, learn the lesson of fighting your failure with courage. And by the way, congratulations for having stood first. But I would have congratulated you even if you would have failed, because I know that you would give nothing less than your best. The girl was inspired and left her guru's room uplifted. This message is not a license to justify failing. We should definitely do our best to get where we want to. But when we can't, due to factors that are beyond our control, we should learn to embrace our failures and accept them as a stepping stone to our success.
Rule number 7, surround yourself with greatness.
Are you surrounded by people who enthuse you, inspire you, motivate you to believe that you can? Or are you surrounded by people who demotivate you, who are envious of you, who are jealous of your success, who want to pull you down so that they go up and make you believe that you can't? Your excellence doesn't just depend on your absorption with practice. Your excellence doesn't just depend on believing that you can. Your excellence depends on your company, people whom you're surrounded by. One of the things I can truly say in my personal life, I found such an incredible impetus for doing what I'm doing today is the company of people. My guru, His Holiness Radhanath Swami, some of my closest friends in the monastery, in the ashram, and in the community that I'm living in, my family, my mother, my sister, you know, my brother-in-law, my grandmother. My father, of course, left this world. And even when he was here, he was also constantly offering me that support, that inspiration, that motivation. Go ahead. You can do it. If you have somebody who believes that you can do it, you will get the belief that you can do it. If you have people around you who are constantly telling you you can't, man, even if you can, at a point of time you start thinking, mere se nahi hoga, because the energy is negative. Like Adolf Hitler once said, you know, if you speak a lie loud enough and long enough, people start thinking it's the truth. So if 20 people around you are lying to you that you can't, and they're lying to you for a long time, you will start believing that it's the truth that I can't.
Rule number 8, change your perspective.
How many of you guys regularly fly? Sure, many of you do. I can see many hands going up there. Well, I spend about 50% of my time flying, trying my tiny bit to help others in whatever small way I can. And isn't it a fact that when you fly in an airplane and look down, the land looks beautiful from the air. The well-organized buildings, natural water bodies, and what to speak of the zigzagging roads, especially when everything is beautifully lit up in the night. Everything looks so organized and perfectly planned. In fact, every single time I fly, I am astonished by the stunning sights. But then, do we experience the same beauty when we are on the land? We crib and complain about how unstructured the buildings are, how bad the roads are, etc., etc., etc. And to be honest, many times they are bad, and sure enough, they need to be worked upon. Yet, when we fly higher, we see a structure, a sense of organization, a sense of beauty. And that's how life is as well. We keep grumbling about so many things that are not right in our life. And surely, like the poor roads and buildings, we need to do what we can to repair the situation. While we do that, however, wouldn't it be amazing to reflect and see that these situations are meant to strengthen us, to improve us, to help us become more responsible? The next time you think you're going through a bad phase, definitely do what you can to resolve it, but also soar higher and see how beautiful it looks from up there.
Rule number 9, persevere through the dark.
Have any of you ever walked into a dark room and not been able to find your way to your bed? Have any of you ever stumbled upon something in a dark room? Have any of you ever bumped into someone in a dark room? In bright light, it's easy to see things for what they are and navigate our way. But when we move to a darker surrounding, a place with low light, it takes time for our eyes to adapt. We are unable to see anything clearly, but eventually we can, thanks to the rhodopsin in our eyes. In life as well, there are the bright times when there's clarity, when we can see situations for what they are, and with great hope, enthusiasm and joy, move on. But then there are times when we move into the not so bright, the darker phase of our life, where we can't see with clarity. Decision making becomes difficult. We are confused. We lose hope. If we have good guidance and support in this phase of our life, and if we can persevere, soon we learn how to make our way, even in this dark phase, and come out victorious, thanks to the rhodopsin effect of life.
And rule number 10, the last one for a very special bonus clip, is don't judge through externals.
There was an old lady who went to a bank and said to the cashier, "I would like to withdraw $500. The female cashier told her, "I'm sorry, madam. For withdrawals of any amount less than $5,000, you may have to use the ATM actually." When the old lady asked why, the cashier, who was irritated, annoyingly said, "Madam, look, rules are rules, yeah? There's a long queue behind you. Please, let me do my work." The old lady replied, "Then please help me withdraw all the money I have." The cashier was astonished when she checked the account balance. She turned to the old lady, leaned down, and said, "My apologies, madam. You have $3.5 billion in your account, and our bank does not have so much cash currently. Could you kindly make an appointment and come again tomorrow, please?" The old lady asked, "Okay, but how much cash can I withdraw now?" The cashier promptly and now respectfully replied, "Any amount up to $300,000. The old lady told the cashier that she wanted to withdraw $300,000 from her account. The cashier did so quickly and handed over the amount to her. Guess what the old lady did? She kept $500 in her bag and returned the balance of $299,500 back to the cashier, asking her to deposit it back into the account, only to leave the cashier astonished and dumbfounded. Isn't it a fact that way too often we end up judging a book by its cover? Many times people around us possess the wealth of deep insights, experience, wisdom, but because of being caught up with the social standards and because of their modest externals, we could easily misjudge and miss out on the opportunity to receive so much. The next time you're around someone, remember, they may possess a wealth that you have no idea about. Stop yourself from judging them, and you may be tremendously benefited by what they have.
Now I have a special bonus clip from Guru on how to be patient that I think you're gonna enjoy. But before that, it's time for the 3-point landing questions. Let's go from just watching a video to taking action. Here we go. Question number 1, what are the externals that you need to stop judging yourself on? Number 2, how can you better surround yourself with greatness? And number 3, what's the passion you need to stop neglecting? And if you like this video and promise to take action after watching it, we don't just watch videos, we do something. Give me a hashtag believe in the comments, and then keep that promise to yourself and get to work.
Rome was not built in a day. Even if you build it right, even if you build it with absorption, even if you build it with belief, even if you build it in the right company, still, excellence takes time. It doesn't happen overnight. One needs perseverance. One needs patience. You cannot get there straight away. All of this impatience and hastiness ruins what we do. We want everything right now. I want what I want, when I went, where I want, how I want. Doesn't work like that, ladies and gentlemen. We need to have perseverance. We need to be patient and keep going with the A, B, C and have the D. Somebody mentioned that, which is the determination, the grit, that if I fail, I'll stand up again and fight. I have the absorption, I have the belief, I have the right company, and after having all this, I'm still going to fail. I'm still going to lose. You have to lose and win many battles before you win the war. In every war, there are multiple battles and you don't win all the battles. When you lose a battle, do you give up hope? Or with great courage, determination and grit, stand up and say, no, I will fight.
If you want another amazing video highlighting excellence in the Indian community, check it out right there next to me. I think you'll enjoy it. Continue to believe, and I'll see you there.